that are mobilized and immobilized based on alcohol use. So we could make aerospace and aviation travel safer. And then narrowed in also in looking at drug abuse by pilots. And even looking at just general medication, like when one is having a cold and takes the Flonase, all these medications they take. And then how about the dose? Because when we are walking down here at gravity, your blood flow pattern is different from when you're 40,000 feet up, when the blood flow is different. And when prescriptions are done for medication, it is done here. So they also need to adjust prescription for those in aerospace or in the cockpit 40,000 feet above sea level. These became the most important areas of my life and work. And then I remember that time I even received an award from the College of American Pathologists, CAP, of Northfield, Illinois. This was a group of professors that would walk into your laboratory, and they were charged with the responsibility of looking at your SOP, your standard operating procedures. Because I was involved in forensic urine drug tests and all these things. But precious people, it was during that journey, it was during that walk, it was during that career track that the Lord Jesus began to speak with me, began to approach me, and it was a long journey of trying to run away from the Lord. The first time that the Lord encountered me in a dream and tried to call me was in Israel. When he spoke to me by voice in a vision, when the cloud of the Lord appeared and the voice called me three times, and he said, I have called you, but unfortunately for me, I was not in the place of advantage where you are sitting today. Nobody had ever told me of the fact that the Lord can call. So I began to run away from the Lord. And that's why this is very critical today to the students listening from Egerton, from Moi University, Masinde Muliro, Baraton, and all those assembled here from University of Nairobi, Kenyatta, Jomo Kenyatta, Daystar, Baraton USIU, Catholic Nazarene. Nobody had ever instructed me on how to behave when the Lord He calls you. Then I did not even understand the supremacy of God over human life. And so I began to run away, and the Lord spoke with me in a dream again at Chicago. And still tried to run away. And at New Jersey, tried to run away. Until finally, he caught up with me at KEMI, the Civil Aerospace Medical Institute. Listen, precious people. What did the Lord tell me when he encountered me in those dreams? The first thing I saw was that in those dreams I was preaching in many countries large number of people were gathered, and people with cancers were healing. He was also healing the cripples, the lame, the blind, the deaf. And yet on this other side, I was so preoccupied with trying to find a cure for cancer, trying to find new medication for this and that, with the different pharmaceutical companies that collaborated with us. And yet, in the dreams, I never told those people that the Lord kept talking to me by voice and showing me big meetings in which I was preaching and people were being healed, including from cancer and HIV AIDS, disability. Hallelujah. Until finally one day, a group of pastors whom I approached, they told me they did not know what to do with those visions, but that if the Lord has called me, I had to obey. The alternative would have to be to be pushed into the stomach of fish. And I repeat, to be pushed into the stinky stomach of the fish, but still at the end be able to go. And so, precious people, I want to encourage you today that when the Lord calls you, please hearken your ears unto the Lord. I want to now share with you some very critical messages of the Lord. Messages that will transform your lives as students. The reason for which I said I wanted you to sit in the forefront. One of the main messages is that of November 1, the year 2006. In the vision of the Lord that took place at 3 a.m. in the morning, the mighty message that has brought forth a big revival across the globe. In fact, we just returned from Paris, France last week, where there's a big revival also lit up by this message I'm going to share here. And in that mighty vision of the Lord, the Lord, He opened heaven in the night and He presented two wedding rings, very golden and very glorious. And He was flipping and tilting them in that dream. And then after that, the voice of the Lord said, "From today on, all authority in heaven and on the earth has been given to Christ Jesus." Now, ever since I began to proclaim this message and give revelation on this word, the Lord has spoken with me about many other things too, even those relating to Kenya as a nation. You remember, when I came into this country in 2004 and told Kenya, "I see a lot of blood coming to flow over your land," and many people quickly wrote me off and published it in the public domain. And I said, "I see blood and parts of human bodies, heads cut off, hands cut off, legs cut off, strewn all over this land, parts of human bodies, vichwa, miguu, mikono zimekatwa na mapanga." And we published, I remember specifically, in the edition of one of the papers, April edition of the year 2005. And I also spoke of the earthquakes that were coming to Kenya. Many people even laughed. And I spoke of the horrendous and ravaging famine that would visit if this nation does not repent. And today I have brought packages of messages here for the Vice Chancellor, the Deans of Students, the heads of the SONU, the student organization, the heads of the Christian Union, that they may look back and see what was spoken to this land and why Kenya is sitting where she is sitting today. Why did the Lord speak to me like that about you precious people and this land? Listen very carefully, precious people. There is what we call the prophetic timeline in the Bible. And much as many times we have lived as casual and usual and daily Christians, living our daily lives as a nation, we definitely knew that a time would come when God will have stricken a given position in the prophetic timeline, a time at which God would now have to demand that we purify our lives and begin to live in the fear of the Lord. And in that conversation of the 1st of November, the year 2006, when he presented the wedding rings in the sky, this is the revelation the Lord is advancing to the church. Number one, that there is nothing God Almighty speaks about that you will not find in the Bible, His Word. And that is why a lot of deception and falsehood and false prophets entered Nairobi, entered Kenya, because nobody bothered to use the Bible as the yardstick, as the benchmark to vet what the false prophets have said. Number two, in the book of Revelation chapter 19, he talks about the wedding of the Lamb of God. I am so blessed that I've come to speak this to the academic community today, because many times in our pursuit of excellence in academia, we so seem to have almost outgrown God. We even forget that it is He that has kept us, helped us to be students, helped us in the exams, the cuts, the final exams. And so, in Revelation chapter 19, verses 6 to verse 9, the Lord celebrates the wedding of the Lamb of God. And that is what is popularly known as the Day of Rapture. The meaning of the Day of Rapture, precious people, is the day when the Lord Jesus, who redeemed you at Calvary, the anticipated day when He will come down and take the Church of Christ into the Kingdom of God. Wow! Then that must be a very important day. And yet the same Bible says that that day will happen like a thief. That means he will come and steal the church that enters the kingdom of God. And ever since you started entering here, and I see a lot of you still entering this place, I was sitting right there and looking at you as you entered. Even now I see more entering. I say, what precious sons and daughters they are. You are my precious sons and daughters. How precious you are to the kingdom of God. And so I began to wonder that, Lord, if you had not sent me here today, probably some of them have never even heard about the day of rapture. And yet, we know that the temporary life we live on earth here will one day come to an end, and then you are faced with eternity. But the question is this: where will you spend your eternity? And that's why that mighty revelation of God that you see in the book of Revelation chapter 19, 6 to 9, talking about the day of the wedding of the Lamb, that is the most important message to ever hit the University of Nairobi. Why? Because you want to win-win. To win here and win in heaven, precious people. If the day of the wedding of the Lamb as described in the Bible, that's why the Lord presented the two wedding rings, wedding of the Lamb. One ring belonging to you, my precious sons and daughters. We are the spiritual bride of Christ. But in that scripture, you see that the entire heaven comes to a complete stop. And heaven begins to celebrate. In verse 6, it says, tremendous felicitation, tremendous jubilation, tremendous celebration consumes the kingdom of God in heaven. Why? Because the day of the wedding of the Lamb has arrived. That right away tells you that as far as the Father of our Lord Jesus is concerned, that is the most important day in the calendar of heaven. But now look at this. How many Kenyans, how many people in Kenya would love to one day be in university like you are, and yet they too are children of God like you are, and yet they have not been given the opportunity you have to sit here? That right away tells you that you have been chosen of God. God has loved you so much that he has pulled you apart as a fraction of this community, this society. You are here in the center of excellence, center of academia. Many have struggled and not reached where you are. But how unwise would it be for you to reach here, beloved that much? Some of your peers have not even arrived. They died of HIV. Some died when they were drunk and had accidents. Some died of disease. and you, he sustained you. How unwise would it be that when even all this is said and done, you miss the kingdom of God? Remember, even when 9,099, again, 9,999 trillion years are up. Again, when 9,999 trillion years are over, eternity has not yet begun. Then would it be wise for gracious sons and daughters like you to finally prepare for the coming of the Lord? Hallelujah. It would be a win-win. Lord, you chose me. You took me to university, you would say. And Lord, look, you also chose me to see your kingdom. What is the point in reaching here and miss eternity? And that's why today is a very pivotal day in your Christian walks, in your Christian lives. If the day of the wedding of the Lamb is the most critical day in the calendar of God in heaven, and yet you are not the child of Satan, you are the child of God. That means even you, that becomes the most important day in your calendar. Listen to me, precious people. In verse 7 of the same scripture, Revelation chapter 19, 6 to 9. In verse 7, he elaborates why on that day celebration will consume the kingdom of God. Because, he says, the bride of Christ has finally made herself ready. And fine linen, bright and clean, kitani kinzuri in arayo, the clean, fine linen, bright and clean, has been given her to wear. And he says, the fine linen is the righteousness of God. The righteousness of the Lord in the church. Hallelujah. That means the Lord is sending me here, my precious sons and daughters, to tell you that the days when university students were known for going to the bars on Friday nights, the days when the students from the universities were known to jump the discotheques of this city, The days when university students, the women, were known to be picked by cars every Friday night, the days when the students of university were known for disobedience, for not caring, the days for immorality in the student hostels, the days for students to go out and take bang and smoke opium, he is sending me to tell you that time is out for those days. Time is over for those. That now the daughters of God cannot anymore be seen in the dark Koinange streets wherever, looking for men at night. That now time has come when the daughters of God and the sons of God should never languish around smoking bang ignorance. Ignorance means you have no wisdom. Get out of ignorance. And to be wise. Now listen to this. Jesus himself. In my Bible, it is in red. The book of Matthew chapter 25. Verses 1 to verse 13. Jesus himself spoke about the day of the wedding of the Lamb. The day of rapture. And what did Jesus say about the day of rapture? He said a parable. He said it is like two groups of virgins. The first group are the foolish virgins. And the second group being the wise virgins that enter. And yet in Proverbs chapter 1 verse 7, the true definition of wisdom is where he says, for the fear of the Lord is the beginning of all wisdom. The universities are centers of wisdom. The universities are centers of learning, excellence, understanding, knowledge. But the true knowledge that can ever visit a university, the true wisdom that can ever be attained from the university, hallelujah, that you can ever come and find from the university, is the fear of the Lord. Then you become a winner. And that is why it is the lack of that understanding of wisdom that has now made our young men go to Mungiki. Our young men opt to serve the devil. Our sons and daughters become unproductive citizens. Join the same train of corruption. And yet for you today, he has poured abundant love that Kenya may have a new hope because of this meeting here today. Let me tell you, you are so critically important for this nation. Because when you will operate in the fear of the Lord, number one, even the sexually transmitted diseases that have ruined the workforce in Kenya will not touch you. Number two, your value systems will have been transformed. Even in the dormitories and halls of residence. Now you will carry yourself with responsibility, respect. And then the rampant abortions in the universities will come to an end. Hallelujah. Amen. You were not born murderers. Why is it that universities are now known to be centers of sexual sin and abortion? It is because the church has not bothered to tell them, look, come on now, stop. It is the fear of the Lord. Let us return to the fear of the Lord, university. Listen to me, my precious sons and daughters. Jesus in that Matthew chapter 25, he said only the wise church will enter the wedding of the Lamb. means those Christians that will walk in the fear of the Lord. Listen to me, precious people. Purification becomes important in your life. I will mention it all here. I love you so much to leave you where you are. For example, in the same scripture, the wise virgins whom he says enter, the jar of oil that Jesus celebrates that they are carrying, that is the Holy Spirit. I am asking that the Christian Union in the University of Nairobi will now centralize the CU on the teachings of the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit is the oil. He is the one that will bring the wisdom of God to you. And remember, when you have the fear of the Lord, the wisdom of God, even your exams will pass well. It's not only heavenly, even here. You become a winner here already. Listen to me, precious students, even in Ingaton and Moi, listening by radio, Masinde Molino, Baraton. Let us return to the fear of the Lord, that we may now walk with dignity and give hope to Kenya and the kingdom of God. Now listen to me. There is need for purification. I know we are going to begin by repenting here today, but the Lord says we must bear the fruit of repentance. My daughters, for example, after today's repentance, you cannot go back to slutty dressing. You will not go back to those mini skirts. Because now you will begin to understand you are the daughter of the Most High God. You are in the image of God. You were purchased at the price. The price of the blood of the Son of the living God. The blood of Jesus. You are not a prostitute. You are fearfully and wonderfully made by God for God. This is the day of wisdom. This is the day to return to the fear of the Lord. The rapture is near. Let us prepare the way in our hearts. You cannot return to those mini skirts. You will say, no, I am not food for HIV/AIDS. But I am fearfully made to be a responsible citizen of this country and the kingdom of God. That is why I'm here today. That no harm will touch you. That you may never be humiliated, my sons and daughters. That nobody may ever laugh at you again. That from this day, you will know that you have a place in the kingdom of God. You are not irrelevant. I know that the church in this country has been preaching a lot of money. Panda Megu. Corruption. The gospel of prosperity. So they forgot to tell you about the holiness of God. But I'm here to tell you that here we are not going to take any offering, neither do we do it in all the 1 million strong meetings I do. Because for once, let it be about the Jesus of Nazareth. For once, let it be about the Messiah. The Jesus of Nazareth. Today, when you go back to your halls of residence, you will understand that you have a personal responsibility to prepare the way in your heart for Jesus who died for you. Only Jesus made you reach the university. Nobody else helped you. The devil never helped you. He wanted to finish you, I know. But listen, precious people, that means purification must begin in your lives. Allow the Holy Spirit to take over your lives, that you may walk a life of purity. Those of you that want to get married, it does not start with cohabiting. It starts in the house of the Lord. Then it will never go wrong. So surely you have no excuse to go into sexual immorality. My sons and daughters, the moment of truth has arrived here. I gave you my lifeline here. How he took me places in academia. But above it all, I cried. I said, Lord, why did you tell me way in advance, much earlier? Because now I understand, we live for the Lord. Hallelujah. And you can never outgrow the Lord. In whatever career you have, he still loves you. He is still the one that died for you.